He killed 25 Taliban fighters, snorted cocaine as a teen, and calls his brother his arch-nemesis. These are just some of the stunning claims made by Prince Harry in his tell-all book, leaked early by bookstores in Spain.
The Netflix series had many wondering, was there anything left for the Duke of Sussex to say? The premature release of his book revealed there was plenty.
I don't know how staying silent is ever going to make things better.
Copies were on sale in Spanish bookshops days before they were meant to be released worldwide. Now we know that Harry says he killed 25 Taliban fighters while serving in Afghanistan. Not a fact that filled me with satisfaction, but I was not ashamed either. He admits he took cocaine several times when he was 17. Details how his father broke the news of his mother's death. Mum has been seriously injured and has been taken to hospital, my dear son. And he says years later, a woman he describes as having powers had a message to him from Diana. You're living the life she couldn't. You're living the life she wanted for you. Of Camilla, he writes, he and William told their father they would welcome Camilla to the family. The only thing we asked for in return was that he didn't marry her. And then there's the rift with his brother.
There's a quote in this book where you refer to your brother as your beloved brother and arch nemesis.
There has always been this competition between us, weirdly. I think it really plays into, always played by, the heir spare.
Harry writes the fallout began over the infamous Nazi costume he wore to a party. He says Kate and William roared with laughter at it, but Harry wore the public shame. And the most sensational claim, in an argument between the brothers in 2019, a seething William called Meghan Markle rude and abrasive before assaulting Harry. He grabbed me by the collar, ripping my necklace and knocked me to the floor. I landed on the dog's bowl, which cracked under my back, the pieces cutting into me. In an interview for British television, Harry was asked whether he's invading the privacy of his own family, in the same way he's complained about the media doing.
That would be the accusation from the people that don't understand or don't want to believe that my family have been briefing the press.
The press getting lambasted again in an interview with US television.
I had no idea the British press was so bigoted. Hell, I was probably bigoted before the relationship with Meghan.
You think you were bigoted before the relationship with Meghan?
I don't know. Put it this way, I didn't see what I now see.
Despite the book being on sale in Spain, booksellers in Britain are still banned from releasing it before next week. But still, the details known already are getting a response from the British public.
Shocking, because no matter what happens among a family, do you really want to broadcast it to the world?
You want the whole world to know your dirty laundry, really? For millions and millions?
Readers can decide how much is an insight into the workings of the royal household and how much is a family feud ripped open.
If you're invited to the coronation, will you come?
There's a lot that can happen between now and then, but, you know, the door is always open. The ball is in their court.
And Europe correspondent Brett McLeod is live at Buckingham Palace. Brett, has there been any response from the royal family?
Amelia, stony silence from Buckingham Palace and Kensington Palace, as there has been all along. But that also means there's been no denial of these very specific and deeply personal allegations that Harry's put in his book. As to the newspapers, well, they've all taken different angles on their front pages, but one seems to sum up the feeling here. The two young brothers side by side, and the headline, "It's all over now." It is hard to see how William and Harry can ever come back from this particular rift, Amelia.
Indeed. Thank you, Brent.